Next chapter we are going to start with the revision is dividends. Time allotted for this is 40 minutes. Okay, like in regular session, don't expect logic for each and every point. I will just go over examination point of view. Exam lo question comes, how to write. No interpretations, nothing. Shall we? One by one, see the screen first. Fastly, I will rush to the concepts. Listen. Dividend includes interim dividend. Hello? 1 second, if you see here and there, concept over. Listen. Dividend includes interim dividend, which means all provisions applicable to final dividend will apply also to the interim dividend. 1 point completed. Next, dividends are recommended by board of directors, declared by shareholders. Repeat, dividends are recommended by board of directors, declared by shareholder. Board cannot declare, shareholders cannot recommend. What I said? Declare. Shareholders cannot recommend. Recommendation will be in the headache of. Declaration is the work of. That's all. 1 point over. Listening, board of directors recommended 10% dividend. How much? 10% dividend. Shareholders can declare less than 10 or 10, but they can't increase the rate. Completed. Read these 2 points first. Which resolution we have to pass? Ordinary resolution. Shall we continue? Next. Next one. Important concepts we are going to be covering. See here. First, let us start with the most important sought after section of this chapter. Section number 123. Listen. There are two areas which are always tested in this chapter. Number one, 123 section. Number two, 127 section. 123. Therefore, first I will cover those two. Once 123, 127 completed, 126. Once 126 completed, unpaid dividend, later EPF. Listening, Okay. This concept takes around 15 minutes time. Remaining will take 2-3 minutes time. We will complete them. Okay. See the screen. Point number one, one by one. I am not going to repeat. I mean it when I say. One time only I will tell, I will go to the next concept. Sources of payment of dividend. There are two types of sources. Internally company sources, external government source. Internal source, from where you can pay the dividend. Current year profits, past profits, or combination of both. Or combination of both. Okay. Or money provided by central government or state government in pursuance of a guarantee given. Number one point completed. Tell me the source. Internal, external. Internal source, current year profits, past year profits, or a combination. When I say profit, that should be after providing for depreciation. After providing for? Very good. Next, past profit. Means accumulated profits, correct? Huh? Which accumulated profit? Revaluation reserve, capital reserve, which reserve? Free reserves. Which reserve? Free reserve means what? Amount freely available for distribution as dividends. Amount freely available for distribution as dividend. Those only we call as free reserves. Understood the point clearly? Next, read this. Internal, out of profits, current year, past combination, or CGSG guarantee. Free reserves only will be included. It will be after providing for depreciation. Profit should not include bloated profits. Real profits only should be considered, not the bloated. Bloating will come because of these four. These are all profits are notional. No, we can call it notional or fictitious profits. Really no profit. Tell me, what are the four? Unrealized gain, notional gain, revaluation gain, fair value gain. Don't ask me the reasons. I told you this is not realization. Remember the content. Okay. Tell me, what is the first one? Unrealized gain. That means if you sell, gain would have come, but you didn't sell. Then why you are writing that? So unrealized gain. FM la You will write one formula, na, D1 plus P1 minus P0 whole divided by P0. Okay, P1 minus P0 means that's an unrealized gain. You didn't sell. If you sell, you would have got that gain. P1 price today, P0 last year purchase price. P1 you are not selling. If you sell, you will get that gain. Those are called as unrealized gains. Don't consider them. Notional gain. My company has a own factory. If like competitor, if I have a rented factory, I would have paid 1 crore rent. Because of having own factory, I am not paying that 1 crore rent. That's 1 crore is a notional gain. Don't consider them. That will be considered for costing. That will be considered for costing, not for me. Next, revaluation. Asset last year, 1 crore. Due to fluctuations in the market value, it revalued to 80 lakhs only. 20 lakhs is not a loss. Even if it increased to 1 crore 20, 20 lakhs is not a gain. Revaluation gain. Likewise, revaluation can be done on two ways. Number one, market value. Number two, fair value. Fair value revaluation or market value revaluation. Any revaluation, you should not consider the gain. Though my intention is not to explain, I explained in a summary. Understood the concept clearly, yeah? What are the four types of gains? Unrealized gain, notional gain, revaluation gain, fair value gain should not be considered in the profits. Out of that profits, don't pay dividends. Next point completed. Transfer to reserves, optional or mandatory? Optional. Whose option? Board of directors. Over. Next. Procedures in paying the dividend. First I will explain, after that you read. 1 minute I will complete lesson carefully. Dividends must be paid only in cash. Number one. Cash represent not currency. Cash means either bank or warrant or electronic means like net banking, NEFT, RTGS, etc. Number three. Whenever dividend is declared, within 5 days, you need to transfer to a separate bank account with a scheduled bank. Within how many days? 5 days. Pay within 30 days. Pay within. Dividends can be paid only in the form of cash, not in kind. Not in? There are two options. Dividend can be paid. Once a dividend is declared, pay only in cash. Instead of declaring dividend, you can issue bonus shares. But once they declared, you can't issue bonus shares. That's why bonus shares can be issued instead of declaring dividend, not instead of declared dividend. Regular class, I told you this so many times. Tell me, bonus shares can be issued only instead of declaring dividend. That means I can stop dividend totally and I can go for bonus. But once a dividend is declared, you can't issue bonus shares instead of declared dividend. What is allowed? Bonus shares instead of declaring allowed, declared allowed. Declaring allowed. Declared not allowed. Everyone understood the concept? Over. Read all this. Okay, completed. Next, see here. Conditions for declaring dividend in the event of inadequate profits are no problem. Extremely important concept in this section. Okay, listen. I wanted to pay dividend even though my company is having inadequate profits or no profits. How to pay? Four conditions you have to satisfy. First, tell me, what is the condition one? Rate of dividend should not exceed average of rates at which dividend is declared in 3 immediately preceding financial years. First condition is what condition? Rate condition. What condition? Rate. What is the maximum rate? Rate means percentage. Maximum rate. Average of the rates at which dividend is declared in 3 preceding financial years. My company have formed 2 years back. Take 2 years average. When I say average, simple average. Which average? Simple average. Number one. Rate condition over. Second, I will draw the amount from existing profits or accumulated profits. Therefore, what they said is, amount drawn should not exceed 1/10 of the paid up share capital plus free reserve. Means you can't draw whatever amount you want. Maximum amount that can be drawn from the reserves should not exceed 10% of paid up share capital and free reserves. Number two. Number three, you draw an amount. Current year loss is there. First set off that balance only you can pay as a dividend. After that, you drawn from the reserves or not. Balance in that reserve should not fall below 15% of the paid up share capital. How many conditions? 1 minute time I will give. Read them properly. We will revise and then go to the next point. I recommend every one of you in the class, please do illustrations given in the study material. You will get practical clarity. Theoretically, you will read in one way. Practically, if you do once, you will get full clarity. Logic, I will tell. Try it at home. Okay, first read this. Okay, done. First, how many conditions? You can write like this in exam, 4 points, 1, 2, 3, 4. Understanding, say, see this diagram. See here, see the screen. This box is accumulated profits, free reserves to be very clear. Entire box la profits are there. You can't take whatever you want. Only some limit is available. How limits will be taken? 4 conditions are there. First point number one. Condition number one. Tell me, what rate you can pay? Average of the rates at which dividend is declared in how many previous years? Rate of 1 year before, 2 years before, 3 years before. Take the rates and divide it by 3. Tell me, I will give one example. 10, 12 and 14. Tell me how much? 10, 10 and 10. Tell me easy. Divided by 3, how much? 10. Means rate of dividend should not exceed how much rate? 10% rate. One clarity came. 10% you should apply on the par value of the capital. What value? Par value. Say my company capital is 1 crore. 1 crore into 10% means 10 lakh. That means your amount to be drawn should not exceed is a wrong answer. It is temporary limit. We have to take other conditions also, whichever is lower we should take. Income from house property, you will calculate standard rent, whichever is lower, whichever is higher, like that. Just because of one thing you should not conclude, you should compare it with other 3 conditions also. Listening, first tell me, what is the rate? Average of rates at which dividend is declared in the 3 immediately preceding financial years. Take that rate. That's a maximum rate at which you can declare the dividend. Listening, that's a maximum rate. Keep that. Second condition. Condition number 2. Tell me. Amount drawn should not exceed 1/10 of the paid up share capital and free reserve. That means total accumulated profits, you can't draw whatever you want. Say for example, our paid up share capital is 1 crore. How much? Free reserves is 50 lakhs. Free reserves, 50 lakhs. Totally how much? 1 crore, 50 lakhs divided by how much? 10. How much I can draw? 15 lakh. Wrong, because 10% limits only to 10 lakhs there. That means how to understand 10 lakhs? Or 15 lakhs, whichever is lower. Understood or not? This is the first point. Everyone understood the logic clearly? If there is any loss, everyone, if there is any loss, from this 15 lakhs, first deduct that loss. 7 lakhs loss is there, yeah, this year. What to do? 15 lakhs minus 7 lakhs. How much it came? Now 8 lakhs or 10 lakhs, whichever is lower. How much only you can pay? 8 lakh, your rate from 10% became 8% now. Understood or not, everyone? Next, after that, that's why clearly I have written amount drawn minus current year losses. Over. Lastly, this is total accumulated box. This is drawn, this is balance after drawn. Listening, that's why clearly I have given here. This dotted line is amount drawn. This crossed line is amount after drawn. Okay, this amount after drawn should not be less than 15% of the paid up share capital. All these four conditions you satisfy, whatever amount comes, that's the maximum dividend you can pay. How many conditions are there? Till all the four conditions? Rate of dividend should not exceed average rates at which the dividend is declared in the three preceding financial years. Number one completed. Number two, amount drawn should not exceed 1/10 of paid up share capital and free reserves. Over. Number three, first use it to set off current year losses. Amount after withdrawal in the reserve should not fall below 15% of paid up share capital. That's all. Four conditions are completed. Everyone confident with all the four? What you have to do after class? Illustrations in the study material you do not, then you will get clarity. Okay, next. Next. This is also equally important concept. What is the name of the concept? Interim dividend. Listen. This I have to explain. Listen carefully. See here. Lot of confusion is there in the student's mind. Let me clear. Interim dividend, I can have four different situations. Shall we? 31/3/2023. 31/3/2023. 10/June/2023. 39/2023. 5/January/2024. I am taking four random numbers. Lo. Listen. First. Dividend one declared here. Dividend two declared here. Dividend three declared here. Dividend four declared here. Okay, na? Or I will make small change. 39/2022. 39/2022. You can easily understand now. First tell me, what do you mean by interim dividend? What do you mean by interim dividend? Dividend, interim dividend means dividend declared between two AGMs. Dividend declared between two AGMs is called as? Is called as? See the screen. Shall we? This dividend is dividend for, which financial year? 22 year la I declare dividend for 22, 23, and the company, year not completed, you will declare dividend, ah? means for which year dividend you are paying there? 21 and 22. Which dividend this is? Final dividend. Which dividend? Final dividend. Because that's a AGM date. 39 assume as a AGM date. I am not going to repeat, I am telling you. 39 is the AGM date. So AGM date, if I declare the dividend, I call it interim or final. Between AGMs, if I declare? Answer. Okay. Now, 10-6-2023. Which date? 10-6-2023. I declare dividend. This will become interim dividend or final dividend. Everyone? Interim dividend. Which financial year it will fall? 22-23 or 23-24? This will fall under which financial year? 23-24 or 22-23? Wrong answer. 22-23-8 will fall. Till the AGM is conducted for that financial year, use common sense here, if any. God has given that. Tell me, 39-2023. Which one? 39. Sir, you will tell that this is interim dividend for 23-24. Correct? How much wrong it is, let us check. After this date came. Here you are declaring dividend for which financial year? 22-23. Under 22-23 final dividend you declared, later after dividend declared for 23-24. Now did you understand? Till AGM is conducted, any dividend is declared, that will be considered as an interim dividend of the last year only. This is what section says. Understood the logic clearly? Yeah? Very, 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 very important content. I repeat one more time this particular point. See here. This is the dividend for which year? 22-23. That means 22-23 final dividend is completed on 39. Then how come you can declare 23-24 financial year interim dividend before that? Therefore, till AGM is conducted, interim dividend belongs to the last year only. Listening or not? So tell me, which financial year this will belong? 22-23 financial year's interim dividend. Listening? But I ask you one question. 22-23 financial year completed or not completed? 22-23 financial year completed or not completed? Completed. By that time completed. Therefore, interim dividend can be paid out of profits of that particular year or even from the accumulated profits. Are you understanding the point or not? P&L account credit balance you can take, or last March 31st ki profits will be there. From that you can pay the dividend, interim dividend. Okay. Next. This dividend comes under which financial year? Now tell me. 5-1-2024 means AGM is already conducted or not yet conducted? Conducted. This will become what dividend? Interim dividend. This will be final dividend. This will be interim dividend for which year? 23 and 24. Everyone understood the concept clearly? Now read. That's why I said listen carefully. We don't have time to repeat n number of times. Read. Period. During the financial year. Next. After the financial year but before the AGM. Sources. Out of the surplus in P&L account. Means P&L account credit balance. Or out of the profits of the current year. Profits of the current year. Next. Interim dividend in case of loss. Sir, if loss is there in the quarter preceding the payment of interim dividend, any quarter preceding the payment of interim dividend, what is the date today? What is the date today? 7th of April. Sir, April means now a financial year start, out of picture. Let us say today is October 9th. Say on random number. October 9th means it falls under which quarter? April, May, June quarter 1. July, August, September, quarter 2. October, November, December, quarter 3. We are in which quarter? Third quarter we will be. Today is October 9th, let us say. We are in third quarter. Go back and see. Two quarters completed. In any of the two quarters, either one or two, if loss is there, interim dividend you can't declare at a unlimited rate. Same concept. Rate of interim dividend should not exceed average of the rates at which the final dividend is declared in the last three preceding financial years. That's all. With this, main section 123 is completed. Okay. I will put it before you. If you want, read for a while. We will go into the next sections. Interim dividend, if you want to read, read it properly. Okay. Shall we move to the next one? Okay. See here. Punishment for failure to declare the distribute the dividend. Dividend declaration or proposal of dividend is optional or mandatory? Payment of dividend is optional or mandatory? Optional. If you declare, it becomes mandatory. I didn't declare. Is it mandatory? No, it is not at all mandatory. From this, what is the moral of the story? Who asked you to declare if you could not pay? Are you understanding? If you give the word that you will pay, pay it. Or else don't say that you will pay dividend. So dividend once declared must be distributed either in cash or through warrants within a period of 30 days. If you don't do that, what will happen? This is what happened. Company, what it has to pay? Simple interest at the rate of how much? 18% for the defaulting period. 18% for the? What it has to pay? Penalty or interest? Everyone? Why? Reason? Reason is very clear. Once a dividend is declared, everyone, once a dividend is declared, it becomes debt due by the company to the shareholder. Debt due by the company to the shareholder. On debt, what we will pay? That's why interest is there. Okay? Number two. This is punishment on company. What is the punishment on the directors in default? Bumper offer given to them. See there. Fine or imprisonment illa? See the fine and imprisonment. First pay the fine. How much? 1,000 per day. Along with that, chalo charlapalli jail. How much? Imprisonment maximum up to 2 years imprisonment. Endara. Now you can understand how strict government is regarding the dividends to the shareholder. Who asked you to declare? They didn't ask. You only said that you will pay. They started hoping that. Market la share price started rising to come dividend. Suddenly you came and said no dividend. Who is responsible for entire loss caused in the market? Therefore, you please go to the jail. Sit there for some days, enjoy and come back. So therefore, tell me the point. Once a dividend is declared, it must be paid within. If you don't pay, what will happen? Company, what is the penalty? What is the punishment? Yeah, simple interest at the rate of per annum for defaulting period. 50 days defaulted now. 50 days into 50 divided by 365 into 18% over. Next, on the directors in default, fine of 1,000 minimum per day. And what, 1,000 is not maximum. Minimum, they can also take it 1 lakh per day. That depends on the magnitude of the company. Second, imprisonment, maximum to 2 years. Endara. And next, dividend declared, not paid. Punishment will get attracted or not? Will not if you fall under any of these categories. Okay, what are these? Let us see. What is the general rule? As per section 127, dividend once declared shall be distributed within how many days? 30 days. Next one. Now, second one is prohibition. Therefore, tell the answer. Therefore, dividend once declared cannot be revoked. Exceptions. Okay? Exceptions. What are the exceptions? Before going into that, no punishment cases. Let us see. No punishment cases. That means in these 5 cases, even though you do not pay the dividend after declaration, there is no problem. 5 cases. Important 5 cases. Number one, by operation of law. By operation of law. Example, shareholder became insolvent. Shareholder became. Obviously, when a person is insolvent, you can't make the payment to him. You paid the dividend through bank check, check came back to the company. Mistake of company or mistake of the shareholder. Then what should I do? In that case, excuse given. Number one, operation of law. Or, listen, I am the shareholder. He is my friend. I said, don't pay dividend to me, pay dividend to his bank account, I said. Company issued a check to his bank account. He is insolvent now. Now company can follow the instruction or cannot follow na? Cannot follow. You should again communicate back to me. Who should communicate? Company. If company do not communicate, it's a mistake of company. I gave instruction. Company tried to follow, but it could not be complied. Again communicate back to me. If communication is given to me, mistake is not with the company. Listening. Number three. There is a dispute in right to receive the dividend. I will discuss about this in next section. Just remember, there is a dispute in receiving the dividend. Next one. You are a shareholder. You have to pay me some amounts in the form of calls. You didn't pay. I am adjusting this dividend to the calls. Lawful adjustment is allowed. Any other reason, not due to the fault of company. Any other reason, not due to the fault of company. One by one, tell me the answer. Point number one. No punishment cases. Give the answer. Operation of law. Shareholder has given instruction. Can be completed, cannot be. What you have to do immediately? Communicate back to the shareholder. Number two. Number three. Dispute in right to receive dividend. Number four. Number four, lawful adjustment. Number five, any other reason not due to the fault of company. In these cases, punishment or no punishment? That's all. Next one. Yes. Unpaid dividend account and IEPF account. In one single page, I completed everything. IEPF and unpaid dividend. See the screen. Just see the screen. Listen, I will first tell you, after that you read. One minute. We'll complete the concept. See here. Unpaid dividend, IEPF. I am not going to discuss about IEPF much. IEPF has only two answers. Debits and credits. You have to remember. Main concept is unpaid dividend account. See here. Dividend declared. Dividend. Once a dividend is declared, within 5 days, you need to transfer it to a separate bank account. From the first date, within 30 days, you have to pay. If no one is there to claim the dividend, no one is there to claim the dividend, wait for 7 days. Wait for, no one claimed it. Transfer it to unpaid dividend account. Transfer it to unpaid dividend account is a separate bank account. In that bank account, all unclaimed dividends will be kept. Summarize, dividend is? Transfer it to separate bank account within, pay within, I could not pay because no one claimed it. I issued a check, address the person is not there, check came back to me. He is not claiming, mistake is with the shareholder, then what should I do? Therefore, I transferred it to which account? Unpaid dividend account, waiting for how many days? 7 days, 37th day came, I transferred it to UPD account. I transferred it to UPD account. Within 90 days from the date of transfer, everyone, within 90 days from the date of transfer, you should prepare a statement. You should prepare a containing names of unclaimed dividends, how much dividend, last known addresses, everything you need to put it in your website. Whose website? Company's website. You need to put. Now story starts. Wait for 7 years. How many years? 7 years from the 37th day. You transferred it to UPD account. Na? From there, 7 years you wait. 7 years, no one claimed the dividend. After the end of 7th year, transfer all the amounts to government account. What is that account called as? IEPF account. Which account? IEPF account. Listening or not? Repeat one more time from the beginning. What are the dates? First, dividend declared. Transfer to bank account within. Payment within. Wait for. So wait till 37th day. Within 90 days, prepare a statement and file it, put it on the company's website. What are the details we need to have? Names, last known addresses and amount unpaid. Wait for 7 years. Transfer the amounts to the IEPF. Okay. Dividend once transferred to IEPF, you cannot claim. Shares relating to that, you can claim. Shares relating to that, we can claim. Debits and credits are these. What are these? Debits and credits to whom? IEPF amount can be spent for these. What will come and fall? Grants from central government, donations, amount transferred from old companies act. Old companies act, unpaid dividend account, IEPF accounts are there. Those balances will come and credit there. Okay. I will invest money or not, that incomes, all these things will be given. Okay. Last only one section is there. What is that one section? 126. What is 126 talking about? Right to receive dividend. Simply this concept is called a dividends kept in abeyance. What is this concept? Let me explain. See here once. This I will explain. Once completed, I will give the break. See here. What is this concept of dividends kept in abeyance? D0, participation required. D0, X, date 0. X sold shares to Y. X sold shares to Y. Y paid consideration to X. Who is the shareholder previously? Who is the transferor? Who is the transferee? Answer. Y is the transferee. Who is the transferor? Who is the transferee? Transfer done today. Okay. Now tell me. Normally, who is the owner? Now, who is the owner? Still X a owner. Because in the records of the company, it didn't change. Just you paid money to each other. Until and unless you send it for registration, change the name, old owner name only will be appearing. Listening, as per the share capital chapter, section number 57, 58, 59, those sections says that whenever transfer happen within 60 days of executing SH4, you need to send it to the company for registration. You need to send it to the company for, okay, what happened? Let me explain. D0, D60. D60 will be last date to send for registration. Okay, this is the last date. 60th day last, I sent on 60th day to the company. Company ki, I sent on 60th day. Company will work on that from that date. Listening, two situations I will take. Situation one. Situation 2. Situation 1. Registration on. Registration on. Say for example, D75. Listening. Second situation. Registration on D125. Registration on D125. First situation. Dividend declared on D70. Dividend. Second situation. Dividend declared on. Dividend declared on D80. D80. Tell me the answer one by one now. Tell me. First, when transfer happened? When transaction happened? Who transferred? To whom? Why paid what? To whom? This is not known to? You tell to the company now. What is the date on which we sent it? Answer. We sent the documents for registration. Registration completed or not yet completed? Not yet completed. Exactly I sent on 60th day. 70th day dividend is declared. Which date? 70th day dividend is declared. Which date? 70th day. Registration completed on 75th day. Now the question is, who should receive this dividend? Is a question. Wrong. Both are wrong. Listen. there is a debate. X will tell that I am the owner in the records of the company, therefore I should receive. Y will tell that, are a stupid fellow, already you took money from me, how can you enjoy the dividend? Both are right or not? Answer. Therefore, in this circumstance, to whom we should pay dividend? No one. No one you should pay. Okay? Keep that dividend in the unpaid dividend account again. Till the problem resolve. Till the? What is the problem? Registration not completed. Let the registration complete immediately. Once registered, pay to the Y. If registration is not done, pay again to the X. Listening or not, everyone? Okay. Now tell me, when dividend is declared? Asal, are you listening? Are you listening really? When dividend is declared? D0 na. D70. Registration completed on? That means just 4-5 days before registration only, dividend declared. By the time dividend is declared, consideration is paid by Y to X or not? Answer. Therefore, Y says that X, you don't have a right. Y says X, you don't have a right. X says that Y, even though you paid, records officially my name is only there. There is a dispute between both of them or not. Till registration is complete, keep in unpaid dividend. Once registration complete, pay to Y. Sometimes registration may be cancelled. At that time, pay to X. Number one complete. Understood the point? Very good. Next, when the dividend is declared. Next situation, situation two. When the dividend is declared. D80. Registration completed on D125. D? Now tell me. When we sent? 60. When dividend is declared. 80. When registration completed. D125. Listening, what is the gap between both the dates? 80, 125? 45. And more than 30 or not? Dividend is declared but not paid within 30 days. It is a contravention or not? But no punishment because there is a dispute in right to receive dividend. That's the last point I left out there. Understood the point or not? Since there is a dispute, even though the period is more than 30, no problem. That's all. With this, dividends chapter over. Completed. Thank you very much. Take break.